Hello, welcome to Ekidel. We are a trained future civil and structural engineer. My name is Justice Omoka and I am your instructor. Today, I'll be showing you the new StoneBridge Template 24 and version 6.0147. Now, as you can see right now, there is two releases of 2024. One is 6.1392, and this new one now is now 6.0147. okay, now there is two difference between these two versions of 6.1392 and 6.1047. As you can see, basically it's not really about the interface, but it's about a quicker way to solve solutions when it comes to detailing. That's what this 6.0147 comes into play. Now, most of you might have issues, or people that have got this template have issues on how to access this interface and make it to work perfectly, because there are some settings that you are meant to do before it will work. Okay, for those of you that don't know what StoneBridge Template is all about, I have done videos on that before. StoneBridge Template is a customized template which is used for your detailing after you're done with your design on Prota Structure software, or on Staadpro software, or on Orion software. Okay, so I have done videos about this StoneBridge Template, so you can watch my videos on that and how to use it perfectly. Now, the reason for this video is to show you why this 6.0147 is more important for you as a civil engineer compared to that 6.0392. Okay, so right now, this other version right now has a decomposed AutoCAD files, just as it was on 2020 version. Okay, now this version right now comes with two interfaces. The first one here is to access it directly from this interface here, where, as you can see, I can access my template based on each of these buttons here. As you can see right now, all the templates are working perfectly based on each of these buttons here. Let me open right now on Beam on Beam Wrap Foundation, and you can see it also work. Now, also for Staadpro and for Steel also, you can see right now it's working in AutoCAD. And if I open for Steel right now, for Steel template here, it will also open. Now, for most of you that are not able to get this interface, or I feel that this interface is stressful for you, now the StoneBridge has come with another way again, which was used for 2020 version. As you can see, let me just go right now for 20 version. Okay, so this is now what this other one comes to play. So once you get this 6.0147, you can see that there is now a new folder here that says STB AutoCAD templates, just as this other one doesn't have it, which is this other one here doesn't have that. Okay, as you can see, doesn't have that. So, but this other one now has it, as you can see here, STB AutoCAD template here. Now, once you open this template now, this folder now, you will see all your AutoCAD StoneBridge templates individually, so you can choose to access your templates here, or even copy to anywhere on your desktop and it will, or on your laptop, and it will still work, compared to before, where you have to save this folder. This folder must be on document folder before it will work. And for it to access this other interface here, it must be a document folder, else this other thing will not work. But once it's on document folder, this other buttons here, everything will like function as it is on StoneBridge template. Okay, but right now with this new 6.147 here, you can be able to copy this one right now out from this place and keep anywhere on, let me say, on desktop now, and keep it on desktop here, and it will work as a normal AutoCAD software, as you can see it here. And it will be able to open anywhere. Let me just start with opening the path foundation template here. As you can see, it is opening directly, and there is no warning compared to other version where you must have to follow all the rules before it will work. Okay, and then you can also go here right now. So this one gives you the right to access all your templates individually, as you can see, this for our pie foundation right now. So now, right now, in total, you will be having a 10 numbers of templates compared to other versions. Okay, this is for a pie foundation, as you can see. This for a pie foundations and all that. And then this is also for, let me say, for steel. Yeah, this is for steel templates, as you can see right now. So you can quickly access it here, while you can also access it directly from the other interface. Let me just open first. So you can see right now. Now, if you need this template, see that you should check the link down below and get that. Okay. So you can see that this is for the steel template. Okay, we have this works perfectly with Prota steel, as you can see that, which I have done before. And then you just minimize this right now. So you can see that you now have 10 AutoCAD templates on your own disposal. And then you also can also access it directly from this place also, which most of the things here have been optimized and all that. But the main purpose of this version is to be able to allow all the users, even the people that cannot access to this interface, can also have their own AutoCAD versions as it is on their own. So once you get it from your purchase that and then download that, copy it into your document folder and unzip it, which I have done videos over the years on how to install this StoneBridge template. Okay, now for those guys that are still new, that don't know what this template is all about, I'll just quickly show you guys now what this is all about right now. Now, this template helps you to optimize your structural drawing after you have done with your design on most of these design software like Prota Structure, Staadpro, and other softwares. Now, knowing that these design softwares are not really good in they don't produce good drawings and good detailing. So this template right now helps you to now optimize those of your drawings. For example, I'll be using Prota Structure software as an instance. So right now, once you're done with your design on Prota Structure, you can get all the folders for your drawings. You can see that I have for the 2018, 21, and 22 working perfectly. So let me just assume now that I did my drawings on 2022, okay, version of Prota Structure, and I now open my drawings now, and then let me just open one of the drawings that was done with Prota Structure right now. You can see that this is how the software gives you your drawing, Prota Structure. As you can see, everything, your beams and everything. Now, if you can print it directly from what you have here, you can see that your drawings will not be to a standard, and your drawings will not be able to, like, they can't read it while they are on site, because it is not to standard, and everything and all the colors, they'll be so dim and dark that you'll be able to see anything. So right now, with the help of StoneBridge template right now, once you get this StoneBridge template here, all you just do is to first thing to look at this thing that was done. Sorry, let me just close all this template here. Is to look at the type of foundation that your drawing, that your design was performed with, because that's how templates, StoneBridge template works. It works with the type of foundation that was used for that building or for that project that you're working on. So let me just close all this one first, close this again, and then close this, okay, and close this again. Okay, that's fine. That's, and then close this other one here, close this again, and then this again, okay, and this again. So let me assume that, let me just open it back again. Let me open again this Prota file again. Now, once you open the Prota file, the first thing to do for you to be able to use this template here very well, let me just see again this template here, which is StoneBridge, very, 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 very well. As you can see that you have several templates here for part from footing, for raft, beam on raft, pipe foundation, slab raft, strap, and all that. For you to be able to use it here perfectly, the first thing you do is to go and look at the type of the foundation that was done on your design file, which you brought from the software Prota Structure or any other software. As you can see right now that this foundation right now is perfectly a part foundation. So right now, what it means is that you are meant to use a part foundation template for StoneBridge to perform your structural detailing for this. Okay, so right now I'll really go right now auto, let me say optimize your drawings. So I'll go right now to the template here. Either I can access it from here, I can see right now it's a building on path foundation, and click here right now, and then it will open the template for the path foundation only, because I am trying to optimize my drawing based on path foundations. Okay, so right now it has opened just now. I'll just maximize right now in AutoCAD now. For those of you using other softwares like ArchiCAD or like CivilSoft and all that, Civil 3D and all that, you can, this one here will be helpful for you. This is the one you are going to use. These other files, which are separate template for StoneBridge, this is the one you are going to use, because this interface might not work for you perfectly. But with this other one right now, you can be able to use this one perfectly. Okay, so once you're done, once you identify your drawing now, you can see this is not a template here. So what you're doing right now is to go here and copy your drawings that was done with Protastructure here. Copy it now. Just copy right now. Copy it from here. And then come back to this StoneBridge template here for the path foundation here. Right click here and then do what here, paste it here. Now this template right now will now optimize your drawing for you compared to what it was on when it was here. Now look at the one that came from Protastructure here, as you can see right now, and look at the one that came from that this software right now has now optimized. This is the StoneBridge template here. As you can see that there is a big difference from what is here before, as you can see that, to what this software now has now optimized automatically. You can check most of my videos I have done for StoneBridge template, right from 2020 version to 24 version. You can see how the template works. I have done many videos on how to perform your drawings, and then from how to get your colons from what it was here, when it was on Protastructure here, to what it is now on the StoneBridge template here. I have done videos on that, and also for your path footing too, and for your foundation layout here. You can see how it is here compared to what it's here before on the AutoCAD, on the Protastructure here, as you can see it here. Now this is the one that you're meant to have on your StoneBridge template. Also cutting your session here, as you can see that. Now you can see how this drawing now, that is template have now optimized your drawing. It has helped you to optimize your drawing, as you can see right now, and also optimize your column schedule here compared to what was here before. I think here, let me see. Okay, here before, yes. And also for your beams, also it has also optimized your beams compared to what was let me say this, yeah, this your beam. As you can see right now, these are your beams compared to what was here before. Okay, as you can see them right now. So this template right now helps you to at least lessen your workload to at least 80% of what you would have done and all that. Knowing that structural drawing is what they take to site for construction and not a design. So if you have a perfect design and you have a poor drawing, a poor detailing, then that building might have issues and all that, and your design will not be relevant. But a good design must come with a good detailing. That is why this StoneBridge template is here to make structural detailing easy, because knowing that drawings basically, or performing a structural drawing, is very, very stressful. So it is here to make your drawing easy, because it will lessen your work to at least 80%. So I have made more videos about this. You can quickly watch other versions of my videos of where I have done for this, and then still relate that same settings. It still works perfectly for this new version. The reason for this version is that most things here have been optimized, and also you now have this on your own disposal. As you can see, you now have this AutoCAD decompose templates here. As you can see there, individual versions up to 10 templates for your own use. Okay. And then also you can see I have done videos on all this. Once you paste your drawings here, the first thing to do is to go and look at what you have here as your sample. As you can see that this is how your beams are meant to look like. I see that this beam right now is showing a dimension of this color, which is good after printing. But what you have here is showing blue here. I can see the blue. So right now to now change it to what it was there. Quickly, this template works perfectly with shortcuts. So right now, just click on this right now. Right click here and then do what says less similar. It will change right now automatically. Then type CH and then enter, and then hold on and then come here. to this place here and pick pick this icon here, and then just click on this and say close. And you can see right now that everything now has not changed. As you can see, everything has changed automatically from green, from blue to like what we have. So in less than some few seconds, once you follow all my rules, all my steps, all my video steps on how to use this template, you'll be able to achieve everything that you have here, on this sample to what you have here. Okay. Now I have also done videos on how to transfer your drawings to this place, to this place for printing. As you can see right now, how to transfer your drawings, just double click here and then zoom in your drawings, which you want to print out. Zoom in at least just like this. And then use, I have taught you how to use a scale for that. Scale, which is I've done, you can see enter and all that. I've done how to bring your drawing to this place, which is Z enter, one all over, let me say 1/100, SP enter, and then you can be able to scale your drawings perfectly on this place. I can see right now. So I've done videos on this before. Let me say I want to bring my beam right now for like printing here. I've done videos on this before. I would just say Z enter, one all over, let me say 70 SP, yeah, and I'll press enter. Okay, and then if it's too small, I will see that I've done videos on that before, so I can just say Z enter, one all over, let me say 40 SP, which is one scale of 1:40, enter, and then you can be able to see your beams here and all that. So you can be able to just arrange it and all that. But let me say I want to use a scale of 1:40, let me say 48 and all, or 49 and all that, and then you can be able to see your drawings perfectly here. So once you position your drawings, and then you can be able to now go and print your drawings out. Let me just say this done nice. Let me know, okay, this fine here. So once you can print your drawings now, let me just say print out now from this place now. Let me say print preview now by using this extent, and then preview here. Sorry, I would have done preview first. Okay, yeah, so you cannot see your drawings perfectly here, but let me just use a finished one that's already done using this template here. Once you go right now, and let me just say, once you're done with your drawing, then that's when you can now print out. Okay, so let me just say I am done with this now. Okay, I'm done with this, and then I can put my drawings here on my template here. Okay, now once I go and now print preview now, you cannot see how my printing will now look like here. You can see how my printing will look like. Everything will be shown perfectly once you're done with your printing and all that. As you can see that right now. And if you want to print using color, you can print using color. Just come here and then change to none, and then print preview again. It now becomes color printing. Okay. And then if you want to change this logo to your own personal company logo, it's very, very simple. All you just do right now is to come here, cancel first, come here, delete this, and put in your own company logo as an image here, and that's all. And you can now go and print it out also the same way, and then your logo will just surface there. Okay, so you can put your logo and all that, and then another that. I've done videos on that before, so this video is just to show you guys that this now has a separate AutoCAD template. So I'll just quickly come here right now, close, and don't save, because I have done videos on that before. So you can now see how this template works directly for the software Prota Structure. Now, the same way it works also for other softwares like Staadpro and all that, and Orion software and Orion and all that. So you can get this template using the link down below. It is not free. Now, if you're having issues with making payments, either using your card or using mobile money, you can quickly reach us on WhatsApp, which is, we have also also our number down below this video description, and you can reach us on there, and then we will guide you on how to get it perfectly, either using paper or any other version or any other way of payment. Okay, so thank you so much, and God bless you. We love you, and let me know your comments down below. And right now, see you again on our 16-story building, which is going for the part 9, which will be dropped this week also. So thank you so much, and God bless you. We love you right now. Then goodbye for now.